Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today I'm going to show you how to draw this tulip and very easily and very quickly. So in this tutorial, you are going to learn the importance of putting the light in the right place. How you can make a very simple drawing very attractive just by using proper lighting and shading. So stay till the end. Let's get to the tutorial.
So first of all, we are going to draw the basic shape of the tulip, okay? Just observe how simply I'm drawing the basic shape, okay? I'm using medium yellow out here. With this medium yellow, I'm going to draw all the basic shapes. The reason for it is that those will serve as the light portion of everything. The light portion means the areas where the light has fallen, be it the flower or be it the leaves. Medium yellow will serve as the color of the light on the tulip as well as the leaves, okay? So now I'm using orange. And I'm just going to give very, you know, simple shading. You will observe that I'm giving very simple shading. Just little bit of blending. Now, some brown. Just to make the, you know, basic shape pop a little. These shadings will act as the, you know, the dark portions. Remember, you have to keep the left side of lighter versions, okay? So here I'm using dark brown. Sorry, that was a vermilion hue. Now some more orange, some blending, and now I'll be using some dark brown. So here I gave little bit of extra brown by mistake. You can always rectify that now. Now if you know the heating technique, it won't be of any issue. So I'm using the heating technique right now. So in case you don't know the heating technique, I'll give a link in the I button so that you can learn the heating technique in details. But still, I'll give you an overview of the technique. All you have to do is heat the oil pastel a little, then blow over it, cool it down a little bit, and then apply the layers. Some little bit more of orange, and here I use some lemon yellow. Now I'm giving some sap green. While making the leaves as well, you have to keep that in mind that you have to make it look like there has been reflections falling on the leaves, okay? So see, I'm giving another layer of medium yellow. Some sap green here as well. Some dark brown. And now see, I made some strokes just by applying lot of pressure. I just made some lines using applying bit of more pressure. So this is the advantage of doing the layering. You can always take off the first layer, I mean the top layer. Some more brown. And now I'll be making some lines using my white glass marking pencil. I use the pencil just to get a blending effect. So I'm using dark brown out here right now again. some medium yellow again. See, it's a very simple drawing. Okay, it's a very simple drawing. You don't have to deal with lot of colors. All you have to do is deal with the shapes, some light strokes using the white glass marking pencils to give the effect of the leaves. And see, some more sap green. And now, see, I have already started working with the black. Okay, that's because, like I said, in this tutorial you will learn how you can make a simple drawing look attractive. Why this is a simple drawing? Because here most of the leaves won't be visible. Most of the leaves will be in the shadows. And majority of the area will be black. So what makes this attractive? What will make this attractive is the placement of the medium yellow, as if the light has fallen from that direction. So when the background is completely dark, you will be able to see some kind of a glowing effect on the leaves as well as the flower, and that will give you that realistic look, that the look where the, you know, the light is bright and it has fallen on the leaves as well as the flower. It will illuminate one side. Now all you have to do is fill up the space with black. Just mark the areas, just mark the, you know, border of the leaves where you want the leaves to be, and make the rest of the areas black. So you have to continue this process. Okay, see, I'm moving on to the other leaves. Here I am using extra dark pencil to mark the outside areas of the leaves to get a sharp edge. And now I'll completely cover the area with black. So now I'm going to completely cover the rest of the areas with black. And just before I go for the, you know, close to the subject, like in this case the flower or the leaves, I'll start using my extra dark pencil to mark the final or the final line of, you know, the sharp edge of the leaves or the flower. That's how it will give you a neat look in an original flower. The leaves won't look blurry. It will have a sharp edge. And to get that, we are going to use the extra dark pencil to give that sharp edge look. Remember, the cleaner your painting is, the more realistic it'll look. So here I am covering the entire space. You see, just for going to the edges, I use my extra dark pencil. Now, some more dark brown. And remember to put some, brown on the right side corner, because in the thumbnail you might have seen there is some little bit of brown. So I put it later on, that's why I missed it out here. So with white pencil, I'm making some light areas to mark the areas where there will be more reflection. And see, now with white pencil, I'm creating the water droplets. I'm just taking away the top layer and putting some dots. Same goes out here. And I'll do the same in the flower as well. See, as soon as the top layer goes off, the bottom layer shines. Now with some black, I'm putting some shadows for the water droplets. And for the finishing touch, I'll just use my white pen. So this is the end of the tutorial. So friends, if you like this video, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to press the bell notification, because I upload a new video every week. So until next time, goodbye.